So we are waiting in line at Uga's Cantina. Here's your drink concoctions. Beers on tap, wine on tap, cider on tap, snacks. I think the front side is just our... Oh, there's more. More concoctions without alcohol. Oh my god, look at the cliff dweller, it's a pork. And more without alcohol. So we're gonna bring you guys inside, give you guys a little look, give you an idea of what our drinks look like, and we'll go from there.
Alright,
Cantina we go, Ashley. We get in here. So this is inside of Uga's Cantina. There's a little robot DJ, Ashley. Jedi to mind trick. What is that?
Oh, they got 825 here. So I hit 1 p.m. and
625.
Alright, so it's like a jello. Yeah. What? But candy. It said
655 before. Try these out. We'll give you our thoughts later.
Yeah, the other
one. Is that like a jello?
Yeah, it's a jello.
Good? Not good?
No, they're really like 840.
I mean, my mind trick's alright. Like I said, I'll give a better
if
view when we're out of here, but... It's not too, too bad. What are you doing again?
Fizz.
Some fizz.
Bespin.
All right. So we'll get your thoughts after, but you can take a sip, see how it is.
They had it earlier, but we just had a bus test.
Not too, too bad. Looks good. Looks interesting.
Inside of here. Tall tables around the outside for bigger parties. And there's stand-up tables as well. Here's our DJ for the night, DJ Ryan. Aside from that, like I said, more larger areas. Big tanks up there around the main bar, so you can sit at the main bar as well. Last time seeing DJ Ryan. Here we go. Alright, Ash, I think that's gonna do it today.
So, we are in the car on our way home from Uga's Canteen. We have opinions. We're letting Alex go first.
I get to go first? Alright, so to give you retrospect, we had appointment at 6:45. Well, not appointment, but reservation 6:45. We got there. They took us on time, so that's probably the one benefit, or not benefit, but
positive.
One positive thing I could say about there is we got taken on time. As you see by going in, it is a relatively cool environment. Star Wars themed, so I mean, I guess there's appeal there as well. The table situation is just a mess. I mean, I've been to bars before. I understand how it goes. I've never been to them that crowded, that kind of just put together. I mean, it kind of sucks when you don't have a place to sit, and I get that. You know, if it's a bar, they're trying to get away from that, trying to not have that, and that's cool. But at the same rate, you can't, like, have people set up and not leave enough space for 8 people to fit at a table if you're trying to crowd 8 people. Because if you probably can't tell by the video, me and Ashley barely had any room from where we were. Because the people across from us that were already established there had already established themselves pretty easily
to be there.
So they had taken up most of our space before we got there. They were already gone by that point, so they weren't even thinking about to make sure that, you know, we had enough space. I literally think we had just enough room for 2 drinks side by side. That was it. So
our little food thing barely even
it
fit
barely
too.
Fit.
You at one point knocked it off
it
the
because
table.
We barely had enough room. Unfortunately, me and Ashley usually have a good, you know, experience in Disney.
It was just something positive to say, but
this is a very bad experience. I would not recommend Uga's Cantina whatsoever. I just could not see a positive. As you could tell, I had the Jedi mind trick. It was not very good at all. I would literally give it about a 5 or a 4.
You'd give it a 4?
It had alcohol in it, and it was a little fruity, but it just wasn't mixed well. It was just very very nothing special about it. It was a poor mixture. It was very weak for alcohol content as well. Like, I couldn't even taste it. I might as well have just gotten a non-alcoholic drink there. Yeah, so it just leaves a lot to be desired. I mean, me and Ashley went into it with, like, a lot of hopes that it would be good.
Because we've never had a negative experience.
We've never had a bad experience. We had hope for the price point that you're paying. Now, on average, cocktails are about $18-16.
Yeah, like, we were hoping it would be decent.
But there was nothing really that great besides what we picked out for our taste. And we looked through the menu. We were hoping for the price point that it was going to be good enough. And it just wasn't there. I definitely was really, really disappointed for, you know, obviously, you know, it's a Disney premium, you know, you're going to pay extra for anything you get, but it just definitely fell
for the price you're paying
greatly short of my expectations. As Ashley said, even after we left, we will definitely be checking out Enchanted Rose instead, because that just seems like a better bet. I'd say skip it. The only I don't know how you get the table, the booths. I think those were nice. That was a nice setup. I think you have to have a fairly large party in order to get a booth, and you have to have a little bit of luck as well. So, yeah, that's going to end it for me. We'll bring it on to Ashley, but I would just say very disappointed. My expectations weren't super high, but they were at the point where I was hoping, you know, it would be a good experience. They'd have good drinks. We'd have a little bit of wiggle room to move around, you know, and check stuff out. And unfortunately, that wasn't the case. I think Disney fell short on, you know, making that a magical experience. I think they could have done a lot better. And, yeah, we'll bring it over to Ashley.
Okay, so, yet again, we don't normally do car, like, finishing the review.
But we wanted to make sure the motions
were passionate about this walking out. Like, I had said multiple times that I'd rather go to Enchanted Rose 50 million times, even though I know that's so expensive. But, like, I'm going to have good time, I'm going to have good service, and I'm going to have a seat.
And you're going to have room.
Like, and I'm going to have room, and I know I'm going to like the
drinks.
Even
if we share a table with people, we're not going to have to worry about running out of room.
Yes. Like, at one point, the people right next to us had a plate, and it was gigantic. And it's not their fault at all. It's a tiny table. Whoever thought that that gigantic plate
was a good idea. Had a bad idea.
It is not a good idea.
Had a bad idea.
But the drinks weren't anything spectacular. I felt like I was just drinking cranberry juice with dry ice in it.
Yeah, mine was very weak as well.
Like, that's all it was to me. We got the little Jell-O thing. I'd say that was
the only highlight
of that experience.
It was just something different.
I'm not a particularly big Star Wars fan. Like, I like the movies and stuff, but, like, I'm not obsessed.
We're both not diehards.
No, we're not.
We love it, but we're not diehards.
That just sucked.
Oh, yeah, it was awful.
Like, I have no redeeming things to say.
I think...
Nothing.
One of the worst parts was just... The other part is how packed it is for, like, reservations. Like, you have to get these reservations in advance.
I've never been to a bar before where you have to stand.
Or... where
there's, like, absolutely no seating. Like, you'll have to get up to go to the bar to order your drink and then go back to wherever you were. But I've never been to a place where you're standing the whole time. I'm thoroughly disappointed. Like, I would maybe give it, like, a zero.
And with reservations,
that entire experience
was a zero. The saddest part is reservations. It's not even like it's an experience where you don't need reservations. You need reservations to get in there.
But
so it's pathetic, kind of, because you need reservations to get in there. You know, you're spending all that time waiting.
I've never disliked something
that
Disney has ever done.
No,
ever.
I agree.
In my life.
I think...
This is the first time I've ever hated something they decided to do.
It, like, unfortunately comes across as for money. It's for profit. It comes across as they just made all these decisions just to make the most buck. And they weren't thinking of, you know, making a great experience for everybody in Star Wars land at this bar, I think. And that's about it.
I am thoroughly disappointed.
Hopefully it changes in time. Maybe we'll catch it again if it, you know, changes. But if
they update it at all.
If not, we're staying away.
I'm never going back there again.
Crossing that off a redo list. So, yeah. That's going to do it. So, as always, I'm Alex.
I'm Ashley.
And this is Disney's Party of Two.